miles ahead right there. That is under the direction of Greg Gil Evans.
This is the real deal, folks.
Man, that is getting right to the middle of the G-square. You know,
ladies and gentlemen, Miles Davis.
Yeah. You know, I traded in a bunch of Bukowski books today to Half Price Books.
Yeah.
And I figured the lasting power of Miles Davis is going to have to outlast the wandering drunk poet. So, sometimes you got to let Charlie go, you know?
Yeah, you do.
Go towards other things. So,
I'm going to hang on to my Joni James and my Billy Collins, however.
Oh, man. Don't even get me started. I did keep some Bukowski. I gave some to my son, Zen. He's going to college.
Yeah.
And I have a couple. I got my first copy I got was from my cousin Maria in Greenwich Village in the late 90s. Very romantic, very cool moment. Parted the curtains in a big way for me, so it was good. It was good. But as we move on here, you had something you wanted to talk about the subjective nature of things.
Yeah. Did a posting here recently. I do a little writing along with this everything else. But I got into the subject, interestingly enough, originally with a guy that does a classical music show, my good friend Patrick. And we started talking about what constitutes good music or bad music. And then I saw this posting later on Facebook, on my Facebook page, from a gentleman who was regaling on what he called bad jazz. And I got to thinking about this. What really constitutes good or bad? I mean, especially when you're when it's also, as you mentioned earlier, subjective. Because as near as I can figure, and it's kind of like this in the art world, okay, as I explained it, there seems to be two qualifications that determine whether or not you've got something, shall we say, worthwhile.
Yeah.
All right? Worth expositioning. One of the qualifications would be construct. Now, I'm not one of these people that is very conversant in the nuts and bolts of composition. I admit that. I know that I am just basically a music lover. I pick up on a few things now and again. But construct seems to be one of them. And the other is what I will call intent.
Yeah.
What your intent is what are you trying to say, if you're trying to say anything? And that would seem to be some of the, at least as I could figure within the art world. Not really whether you like it or not.
Right.
It's sort of a matter of taste.
Right.
You know, it's kind of like this. If I approach a painting,
right,
and I said, man, that thing is loathsome.
Right.
I hate this thing. The artist is likely to come up to me and say something to the effect of, well, it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
It's a loathsome subject.
Yeah.
Okay, so in other words, you're very good at expressing loathsome, apparently.
Yeah.
And, all right, good, bravo.
Right.
You know, what, ultimately, you got guys with instruments getting up on a stage, and this is basically what the guy that was posting said. Basically, you heard guys on the stage, each with an instrument, going off in all different directions, and the dissonance was first of all unpleasant. And if a reviewer was to approach this individual, the artist that is, and say, or let's say the reviewer did a review that said, it sounded to me like these guys really didn't know what they were doing.
Right.
So they do an interview with the artist and they say, exactly.
Right.
And they say, what? Well, that's the name of the song, as a matter of fact. What are you talking about? Name of the song is We Don't Know What We're Doing.
Intent.
Oh, okay. Well, bravo then.
Yeah, right.
But is it particularly ennobling? Is it useful? That's kind of the other one.
Well, I mean, art for art's sake, yeah. I mean, is it useful? Is it pleasant? Is it, it's like the painting that they didn't like. You got an intended effect out of it. I mean,
I suppose.
I mean, but at the same time, it's funny. I'm going to go on an offshoot on this, which
All
is
right.
interesting. Fred Armisen came to Kansas City and did a stand-up. He's on Portlandia, and he's the drummer and band leader for the Seth Meyers late night show.
Yeah.
And he railed on jazz and went on about how all these guys, just like you said, are all on stage doing separate things and kind of generalize jazz. You know, I've covered this enough, and I've played enough shows up to this point to know that these guys aren't generalizing anything. They're having conversations. It's improv. but it's not sloppy. And that's the thing that I find ballsy about what Fred did, to come into a jazz town and basically say, I don't like this idiom that was created in one of the four cradles of American city, and then go on and on about how it doesn't. So it's just like you said, the intent of all the most, I don't think I've ever heard a song and thought, man, these guys are deliberately going up there and hacking and throwing and doing something wrong.
I don't know. I caught on one of your magazines that you gave me an interview with Captain Beefheart.
Yeah.
Okay. As he attempted to explain what he was doing, and I got lost in the first few words. You do have to ask the question. I mean, just to keep your sanity, what is the difference between avant-garde and just being able to say, "Boy, that sucks."
That's true.
Yeah.
That's very true. And
it might just. You know, you were talking about an artist. Remember the artist that used to stand up on a ladder?
Right.
And he would just dump paint?
Yeah.
From 10 feet up, and whatever splattered on the canvas was what was there.
Right.
He might lie on his back and make paint angels.
Right.
And then this thing, you know, sells for $5,000.
And we're talking about it. It's like the bad commercial on TV.
Yeah, maybe.
Why
so.
The hell did they make that? Well, you're talking about it. That's what it is. It's all about maximum saturation. It's
well, isn't that called commercial, though?
It's commercial. Yeah.
Yeah, because that's the other one you hear a lot about. Oh, you're a sellout, man. You're just trying to be commercial. Or you're trying to get my attention. Which Mr. Trump is doing a very...
Yeah, Trump's doing a great job of that.
Yeah. He's getting our attention, all right, but quality, and is it art? Nah.
No, it's quantity from a spoiled, rotten, Richie Rich 8-year-old kid that's not getting his way is what it is.
Yeah, but everybody's watching.
Yep, everybody's watching that wig dance around there. Oh, man, the election, we got, and just realize, we got 3 more months until this thing happens, so no matter how this ship turns around and the sails go around, 90 more days at least.
Yeah, and I'm an engineer for a 9-station radio cluster, and I have to pass through the newsroom at least 50 times a day. I was with one of the other techs, and we were watching, I think it was Trump on CNN being interviewed. And he says, in his pure techie way, boy, this country so needs a reboot.
Yeah.
And I popped in there with, yeah, but we better reformat the hard drive first.
And clean everything off of it.
Clean it all out.
Every single ounce. Trump that thing right in half, you know. Yeah, that's the reason why this is an oasis for us to get down here and make these shows. Because
really,
you escape that narcissistic Washington, D.C. zone. And I've been actually on a detox for news for a while. I can't really take it. I've paid attention to enough. I didn't watch any of the conventions to know what's going on, but it's nice to just listen to Miles Ahead and let that music just sail away like a bird in the sky.
Lay down with a good book and put on some Miles. You'll probably do yourself better over the long run. Oh, yes, stay informed, but don't drive yourself nuts. My father used to work in the newsroom, and that was his advice. Stay informed, but don't drive yourself crazy.
I read the news today. Oh, boy.
Yeah. In other news.
Other news.
No wonder we're talking about, you know, stray bears in the neighborhood as opposed
yeah, exactly.
Anything else.
Anything. Hey, did you see that orange crush can in the middle of the road? That's where we're at.
That's called breaking news.
That's
anymore.
Right. The broken oranges in the road. Oh, man. Well, yeah, this is good. What a great album, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody, I just shut up and let it finish.
Yeah.
Or at least this song.
That's right.
Miles Davis, ladies and gentlemen, glad you could join us for our, what do we call this thing?
Have a nice life. No, Neon Talk.
That'll work.
So with that in mind.
In the Butta Bing Studios.
Enjoy your life, kids. Thank you.
Neon Jazz.